through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, a descendant of David. Such is my gospel for which I am suffering, even to the point of chains like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I bear with everything for the sake of those who are chosen, so that they too may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus, together with eternal glory. This saying is trustworthy. If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we persevere, we shall reign with him. But if we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he will remain faithful, for he cannot deny himself. Remind people of these things and charge them before God to stop disputing about the word. This serves no useful purpose, since it harms those who listen. Be eager to present yourself as acceptable to God, a workman who causes no disgrace, imparting the word of truth without deviating. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Teach me your ways, O Lord.
Teach me your ways, O Lord.
Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your path. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior.
Teach me your ways, O Lord.
Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice. He teaches the humble his way.
Teach me your ways.
All the paths of the Lord are kindness and constancy toward those who keep his covenant and decree. The friendship of the Lord is with those who fear him, his covenant for their instruction.
Let us pray.
our church, may the Holy Spirit help us never cease to proclaim the good news, we pray to the Lord. For cities across the country, that there be an end to civil unrest, we pray to the Lord. For prisoners and persons incarcerated wrongly, and for political prisoners, let us pray to the Lord. In thanksgiving for the generosity of our many friends and benefactors, we pray to the Lord. For the ill and infirm members of our community, and for all we've been asked to pray for, especially Kathy Kovalinsky, Dorothy Hoover, Pauline Trzynski, Ellie Triska Palacios, and Mildred Pierce, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed who have gone before us, marked the sign of faith, especially departed confreres, parents, relatives, oblates, benefactors, friends, and alumni, that they may share in the full glory of the kingdom of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Now let us pray for the living by sacrifice and the gifts of the Holy God, the Almighty God. Salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. thanks, Father, most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you, O holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Oh. Holy Spirit,